So if you're using Google Sheets, a lot of times you'll be using cell references. So a cell reference is just a way to tell Google Sheets where to look for a value. So let's just do a real simple example here. If I just come off to the side of this spreadsheet, so I'm in F8 right now. You can tell this is F8 because F is the name of the column and 8 is the name of the row. You can also see that by going up into the name box here in the upper left-hand corner. And I'll just type a simple cell reference. So you always start them out with an equals. Equal sign is telling Google Sheets, I'm going to give you instructions here. So I'm not just going to type a series of letters or numbers. I'm going to actually ask you to do something. And here we'll do the easiest cell reference there is. We'll just say A1. All right, so all that's going to do is look in cell A1. The blue letters here are already telling you what's going to happen. It's just going to grab the value of A1 and show it. All right, let's hit enter, and it just returns sample data. So that's the easiest way to type in a cell reference, or at least the most intuitive, is just to type it right in the sheet. Let's go up, let's delete that, and we'll hit enter again. So Sheets is ready to get instructions again. We're going to tell it A1, but we'll do it a different way. So we can use our arrow keys to move around. So I went up and then left. I'll go up again, and I got to A1. Hit enter. Sometimes that's easier depending on how you're working with your sheet. You can also go in here and use the mouse. So we can grab A1 that way as well. I'll delete that. And then if you go into a place where Google Sheets would be expecting a formula, so it's using some AI to analyze what you're doing and try to help you out, it might actually just give you a suggestion of a cell reference. So let's go into E7. It's going to be expecting you to sum this column, right? I hit equal and it already does the entire formula. You don't even have to type in sum here. So I could just hit tab. It has the name of the function. It has a cell reference. So it has the entire formula all done for you. So a lot of times that is going to come in handy and you can just use it and move on. But it's helpful to understand what a cell reference is. So if we go back and look in here, it said E2 and then a colon through E6. So what that is, that's two cell references, right? One is the beginning of a range and one is the end. So if you specify one cell reference, use a colon, specify another one, you're telling Google Sheets to use everything in between those two references. In this case, in Sheets does this, I don't know why, it grabbed the cell header also, so it's trying to add the word total that's in E2. That's okay, it's not going to hurt anything. If you want to be real exact though, you can just change that to E3 to only be grabbing the numbers. The result will be the same, hit enter. So those are the different ways to get a cell reference into your cell. So let's talk about the different types of cell references once you're using them. We'll pop this up again and you'll see E3 through E6. If I take that formula and I copy it and then I paste it into D7, actually let's paste it into C7. You don't really want to add up the cost. It probably makes more sense to add the units. That formula adjusted. So we call that a relative cell reference. If I go back into the cell, instead of E3 through E6, it automatically changed it to C3 through C6. So that's called a relative cell reference. And most of the cell references that you use will just automatically be relative. And that's kind of one of the things that makes spreadsheets so powerful, is that when you copy and paste formulas around your spreadsheet, they're smart enough to adjust because they're relative cell references. But you may want to use a cell reference that's fixed. So we'll go over that in this example. We'll go to the worksheet called Fixed Reference. And there is a link to this spreadsheet. It's in the description of the video. It'll take you to a link to the website. All right, and you can always, let's say, using cell references. So this will be sheetshelp.com/cell-references. You can get a copy of the spreadsheet if you want to follow along. Just bring it up and then go to File and make a copy. It'll put it right in your Google Drive. So here's a scenario where a relative cell reference isn't going to work very well for you. So what we want to do is we want to multiply the total in A3 by the tax rate. So we will say, we'll do it the wrong way first. We'll say A3 and then times, and the tax will be in B1, or the tax rate. We'll hit enter. And the tax of $9.45 is right for row 3, but then in row 4, I'll show you what happens. We'll just take this auto suggestion for now. It is right to multiply A4 by the tax, but then the reference to the tax shifted down one because the formula went down one. So that broke the reference. It's not working. It's not pointing where you want it to. So we'll hit escape. We'll come back into, actually, we will delete B4 through B6. And we'll come back into the formula that we put in B3. And what we want to do, we want to tell it not to shift down every time we do the formula. So we're going to change this from a relative cell reference to a fixed cell reference. So we can use a dollar sign to do that. And we're going to fix the row reference. You can also fix the column. Okay, in this case, we don't need that because we're not changing the column. So we'll just leave that off. But every row that uses this formula now is going to reference B1. So we'll hit enter again. And it auto suggests different results this time. And these results look right. So we'll hit the check mark. We'll come into B6. And since the reference to B1 is fixed, it's still correctly pointing there in every row. The third type of cell reference that you can use is that you may want to pull in something from another sheet. So in this case, we have, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4 sheets in this file. You can call them a worksheet. You can call them a sheet or a tab. No matter what you call them, I'll show you how to reference them. Let's just say we want to pull in something from the unformatted worksheet. The easiest way to do it is to hit an equal sign and then come over with your mouse, go to unformatted and pull in. Let's say we wanted this total for some reason in E7. Just click on E7 and you can see it's already building the formula for you. This is a preview of what's going to go on the sheet that we were on. Just hit enter. And there we go. So this is a cell reference to another sheet. And if you double click into it, you can see it's the name of the sheet followed by an exclamation point. That's all it is. There is one trick. If you're referencing the name of a sheet that has a space in it, you have to put apostrophes on each, before and after the name. You can do it if there's no space also, but you just don't have to. And that makes a valid cell reference. So this, you could combine concepts here, right? If you needed to copy this down and you wanted to fix the row, you could do that in here. So it's a fixed reference to another worksheet. You hit enter and it brings that value from that worksheet into this one. All right, and the last way to do a cell reference is something called import range. And that's how you reference a cell that's in a completely different file. So there is a formula that you need to use to do that called import range. And it takes the URL of that other spreadsheet. So that's this number that, well, letters and numbers that you see in the address bar. You would get that value from the other sheet, put it into this formula, and then tell it where to look in that sheet. All right, so if you want to see more on that method, I've put a link in the video on import range. Click on that. It's a little bit finicky on how it works, but it's not too bad. I think you can learn it if you need it. And we'll go through one more tip here before we wrap things up, and that is the way to do a kind of a never-ending cell range. So let's say you're continuously adding values onto this table that we have right here. So we'll do a formula off to the side. We'll say we're going to average it. And if you did a traditional cell range like E3 through E6, so I just did that with my keyboard and hit enter, that's all fine and dandy, right? 476. But if I add a new row and I'll make it really large so it would throw the average off, it doesn't change anything. Google Sheets is smart where you move things around, it can adjust. But if you add rows, you have to be careful. It doesn't always know to put them into the formula. But something that you can do, let's come into this formula. And you can say, let's start it at E3, but just never end it. So you can just take the ending row completely off. And as you see, the average went way up. All right. And if I add something more to the end, so we'll just do an even larger number, you'll see the average change. All right, so be careful with this technique because maybe you don't want the range to expand automatically. But if you do, that's your little bonus tip for you. And now let's talk about how to use these cell references and formulas. So we'll talk about the bigger topic of how formulas work in spreadsheets. I'll see you in that video. Thanks for watching.